In the programs that you've seen so far, you've used a single loop to solve a problem. Sometimes you need to have more than one loop, and in fact it can happen that you have one loop sitting inside another. Such loops are called nested loops. Let me give you an example. We want to write a program that draws this square of colors, starting with a black one, increasing the greenness in this direction, increasing the blueness in that direction. How can we draw all of these squares? Let's think of it a row at a time. For example, to draw this row here, I need to go from x equals 0, then to x equal whatever the width of this square is, which is 30 in our example, so that x equals 30, 60, 90, and so on. And that'll be a loop. That loop will draw all of the squares in a particular row. To get to all rows, I need another loop. And there you have it, a loop inside a loop, nested loops. Now the only tricky task remains, if I have row I and column J, how do I find out the position and the color of this square? You'll get to try that out in the next exercise. Just keep in mind that as the row index I goes 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, you want the Y position to be 0, 30, 60, 90, and so on. And as J, the column index, goes from 0 to the number of columns, you want the X offset also to be 0, 30, 60, and so on. How about the colors? We want the square down here to have green 255 and blue 255. All the reds are 0. So you want the greenness to vary from 0 to 255 in equal increments in this direction, and you want the blueness to vary from 0 to 255 in equal increments in that direction. You just have to figure out the increments. All right, go ahead and give that a try, and as you do that, closely look at those two nested loops that you'll be working with.